Continuous integration and continuous delivery are two important steps inside of software development lifecycle. There are several tools offered by the market nowadays, and they could fit properly into the MuleSoft tools too. Some examples are Jenkins and Microsoft Azure. Both of them could offer automated deployment and delivery. And that's why in this video, I will show you how to use Azure for your projects. In this video, we're gonna create a MuleSoft application with Anypoint Studio, a pipeline in order to release the deployment we are gonna do through our repository. But before we begin, let me introduce myself. I'm Lorenzo Neri, and I work as integration engineer for Capture Lab. My coworkers and I create several contents in order to let you understand better the MuleSoft world. So, do not forget to subscribe to our channel. As I was saying at the beginning of the video, we are gonna create a pipeline. A pipeline is part of the CI/CD in order to deploy constantly updates to our project. We need several things to begin with. The first one is, of course, a MuleSoft project created with Anypoint Studio. So here, actually, we have a really simple project composed of a simple flow. The most important first step is to create a repository inside of the main folder of the project. You can create the repository in any way you want. From my personal perspective, it's better to create it by a CLI, and that's why I'm currently showing you this terminal window. The other thing we have to do is to create, moreover, the main branch, another branch that we could name deployment. Deployment would be the branch connected to the pipeline we are gonna create with Microsoft Azure. Before to proceed, we need to create one file that is named Azure Pipelines with all of the related Maven details in order to create the pipeline in between Azure and Cloudhub. To do so, the first step is going to the POM file, clicking over source in order to see all of the XML tags and having a look under the plugins tag. We have to find it out, here we go, with the Maven plugin, and under this tag, under configuration, we have to add other XML tag that I left into the video description. So over here, before the closing tag, I'm gonna add this portion of XML. Let me explain what I've added so far. So the tag CloudHub deployment is used to connect in between the application and our CloudHub account. Indeed, as you could see, we have our URI, which is anypoint.mulesoft.com. Of course, it will change according to your project, because you might have deployed over EU1 or any other CloudHub domain. Then we have the Mule version. It has to be current to the your project version. The username and password tags have to be valid according to your CloudHub account. The environment, of course, is the environment where you would like to deploy the application. Application name, it will be the name shown over CloudHub. Worker type is the size of the worker itself. According to your need, you could add it to micro and to the other available values. Once we are done with the POM file, I will create the file I was mentioning before, which will be Azure Pipelines YAML. I will copy paste the content inside of Azure Pipelines YAML file. Gonna explain you what is written over here. But before we keep going with this explanation, let me explain what is written inside of this file. The first thing is the trigger. This trigger includes inside of it branches and the branch I named before, which in this case is deployment. This part is required in order to let the pipeline understand when it has to be triggered. What do I mean is, as soon as we do a commit over this branch, the pipeline is listening to updates related to this branch, so that as soon as we push a commit over this branch, the pipeline will execute the deployment to CloudHub. Paths are exclusion rule for files. Why do we need that? We need to exclude the POM and Azure Pipelines file because they are already considered to the Azure pipeline, and we will see that after. Steps are related to Maven. Maven will be part of the deployment, and we will see after in turn, always via Microsoft Azure website. Here we could see the Maven POM file, which is POM XML, the ordinary one used by MuleSoft. Goals is a clean install related to Mule deploy, where we put the server, environment, worker, the worker type, runtime, and the app name. These parameters come from the POM file. We saw it before. Okay, now that we are done, we're gonna do the checkout to the other branch. We bring the updates, so once we are done, we're gonna push the updates to the remote. If you haven't already done, you need to have a remote repository, like I was saying, GitHub, Bitbucket, whatever. In this case, I'm gonna use GitHub to keep it simple. Once we are done, we go to Microsoft Azure website. The first thing you have to do is going to dev.azure.com website. In my case, I'm already logged in. And the next step is to create a new project, which is in my case, this one. When you're in this section of the project, you go to pipelines. Here I have an already existing pipeline, but I'm gonna delete it in order to let you see what you have to do. So I'm gonna delete it. Click over the button, new pipeline. As I was saying, it's up to you. You can use other Git, Azure repos, Bitbucket, GitHub. In our case, I'm gonna use GitHub, the first option. I will select my repo. And here, we're gonna to configure the pipeline. As you could see over here, there's the file, in this case, the Azure Pipelines YAML file that we wrote before, including the branch to be considered, the excluded files, and the other related Maven configuration parameters. Once we are done, I click over run and the pipeline is being created. Here in this section, you will see that the pipeline has been created with all of the details related to my repo, to the branch, to the commit hash, etc., etc. In this case, you will see, of course, 100% case you will see, like me, this error, no hosted parallelism, etc., etc. This is because you have to fill out a form given by Microsoft. If you click over the job, like I did so far, you could see no hosted parallelism. Okay, my English is not as good as it has to be. You scroll on the right side and you see over here, please fill out the following form. We're gonna copy, paste the URL over the browser and we land. Okay, cut please, Mason, you will. We copy paste the link and we land over this page where we have to put our name, our email address, which has to be the same exact you use to register over Azure website, what is the name of your Azure DevOps organization, etc., etc. Once you are done, you will receive an email from Microsoft Azure confirming your registration. Final consideration over Azure pipelining is as follows. First of all, in order to execute the pipeline itself, we have to go over here and as soon as we do a commit over the named branch, which in this case is deployment, the pipeline will start. Of course, we have to wait the final confirmation from Microsoft, which takes up to 2 or 3 days. Once Microsoft gives you the access to Azure pipeline, just the time to change location, cut my hair and change my dresses, we can keep going with our project. What we have to do is a simple edit to a file, like whatever, it could be a simple text file over here. I can add some stupid stuff, like so. Save the file. And what I have to do right now in order to start the release on Azure Pipeline is, of course, to do a commit and push it over the deployment branch. So here, git add text, git commit minus m, stuff added. Git push, and in a couple of seconds, you will see that the deployment over Azure Pipeline starts. And if the deployment of entire pipeline is successful, you're gonna see over AnyPoint platform that deployment of your application will start in a couple of seconds.
Then afterwards, we'll have a look about the status of deployment. And once we'll see that the application is started and of course that the green light appears, then we are successful. Once we did all of these steps, let's get back to Luxembourg a couple of weeks ago.
In conclusion, what I should say to you, first of all, this option offered by Microsoft is partially free. As partially free, I mean that Microsoft offers you a limited amount of resources given by Azure Cloud. And of course, if you are willing to create a more complex project, more projects in turn, you have to activate a subscription plan in order to be free of any movement. So these are the required steps in order to create your pipeline through Microsoft Azure and start a continuous integration and continuous delivery for your project. The latest point is to let us know what do you think about this video into the comment section. Thank you and see you in the next video.